पन्दे वांछित लाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दंपति मिति ब्रूयाम उताहो दंपति इति सो वी आर लुकिंग एट सेकंड आश्वासाम वेर दे हैव रीच द सत्यलोक एंड सनत कुमार नोज दैट बृहस्पति हैज अराइव्ड एंड ही ऑर्डर्स हिज डिसिपल्स टू गो एंड bring Brihaspati along with the Amara Devas with the honor. He asked them to bring them to his presence. So I think we finished with the shlokam. Atha Suragurum Agatam Sashishyam Swayam Avadharya Dhiya Sanat Kumaraha Apagata Tamasaha Mahaprabhavana Ashishat Amushya Sabhajanaya Shishyana Amushya Sabhajanaya. In order to honor Suraguru, he ordered his Shishya Shishyana Ashishat who Sanat Kumara. Now these Shishyas, they start on their way Prasthitaha Chate. So they start and as they are walking towards Suraguru, Brihaspati, who is there, they are talking about Brihaspati's Mahatmyam amongst themselves. They're talking to each other about the greatness of Angiras in this Gadhyam. Can you read that?
Oh, Nana. Prasthitascha te paraspara alapeshu अथर्व शिखा प्रवर्तकताम अंगीरसाख्य योग रहस्य प्रवर्तकताम ऋग्यजुषोद्घुष्ट प्रभावताम अपि अनुस्मृत्य प्रशंसन्तः ब्रह्मपुत्रं भगवन्तं तम अंगीरसं.
So where it goes and ends at Sanat Kumara Samipam Aningire. So they are Prashamsantaha. Everything is an adjective for Te, which is the Shishyaha. So Te Shishyaha Prasthitaha Vinirgataha Sanat Kumara Samipat. So they, as they left Sanat Kumara, those students who started from there started praising Angiras. Angirasam Prashamsantaha. So Prashamsantaha Brahmaputram Bhagavantam Tam Angirasam. So as they were praising Brahmaputra, Brahma's son Angiras, which is Brihaspati. So they were praising Brihaspati. How were they praising him? Anusmritya, by remembering different things. They were thinking about how he is the guru of Atharvashikha. Atharvashika Pravartakatam, his the state of his being the Atharva Veda's Pravartaka, one who teaches that Atharva Veda. So Atharvashika Atharvashika Pravartakatam, his state of being the preceptor of Atharva Veda, and then Angirasakhya Yoga Rahasya Pravartakatam. Yoga Rahasya, Angirasa Yoga Rahasya is also another teaching that Brihaspati is supposed to have started and he is supposed to have taught others. So Angirasakhya Yoga Rahasya, the Yoga Rahasya which is named after him and which is named as Angirasa, he is also the teacher. So they are thinking about all of these things about Brihaspati. The next one is Yirik Yajusha Udghushta Prabhavatam. His Prabhava, his greatness is being described in Rig and Yajus, Yajurveda. So Rig Yajus, when those two join in a samasa, it becomes an akaranta. Akaranta. So Rig Yajushabhyam Udghushtaha Varnitaha Yase Prabhavaha Tattam Tasya Asti. Tadapi anusmritya. They were also thinking about how his greatness is being praised. You know, see, when you're going to meet someone, it is very natural that you're talking about them, right? So there are so many things to talk about this great person who is Suraguru, who is also the teacher of Atharva Veda. He teaches the Yoga Rahasyam. He's the one who started the Pravartakaha, also means he is the one who established or Prakashakaha, one who made it known to the world about these things. And his greatness is also being described in Rig and Yajurveda. Iti Prashamsantaha. Next.
ब्रह्मपुत्रं भगवन्तं तमङ्गिरसं प्रशंसन्तश्च गूढचर्यारतं महर्षिं संवर्त शिवाचार्यं
मरुत अनुग्रह
अनुग्रह वारण
वाराणसी वाराणसी एक्चुअली वाराणसी
मरुत अनुग्रह वाराणसी निषेवन व्रता व्रतादि उपाख्यानेन शंसन्तश्च
இருக்கட்டுமா சோ பிரசம்சந்தா மகர்ஷிம் சம்வர்த்த சிவாச்சாரியம் சோ தே வர் ஆல்சோ பிரேசிங் சம்வர்த்த சிவாச்சாரியா ஹூ இஸ் பிரஹஸ்பதிஸ் பிரதர் ஓல்டர் பிரதர் சோ போத் ஆஃப் தெம் வர் சப்போஸ் டு பி இன் இட் இஸ் தேர் இன் ஆதிபர்வா துவாவேதௌ அதிவிக்யாதௌ சுதௌ அங்கிரசா முனேஹே ஸ்லாக்யௌ ஆசிரயதா ஜீவ சம்வர்த்த சிவ சம்யகௌ So two of them are praised as Angiras, Muni Angiras' sons. One is Brihaspati and the other is Sambartha Shivacharya. So Sambartha Shivacharya, Gudacharya Ratham, he is involved in practicing Gudacharya, that which is not known to anybody. Rahasyena Saha Charyam Pujam Karoti. So Rahasya Vrata Niyama Yuktaha Saha Tam Prashamsantam. And where was he staying? There is a king, it is in the Puranam, where it says that Maruttaha is a king who was in Varanasi. And this Sambartha Shivacharya, in order to show his anugraham towards him, he went there and stayed, undertook Vratam and also performed Yaga for him. He was the Marutta king was the Yajamana and Sambartha Shivacharya was the person who was the Ritvik. So here they were praising his brother. So you generally not stop with one person. You know, his brother is also famous. His sister or his father is famous. So the same thing, you don't generally, you will talk about the kulam and everything else as you are going to meet that person. So it's a very, very natural portrayal of what is happening there. Svabhavokti. So Gudacharya Ratam Maharshim Samvartha Shivacharyam. How are they praising him? Prashamsantaha. By talking about Upakhyanena, by talking of his Vratam. Vratam, Vratadi. Vratadi meaning Vrata and the way he performs the Yaga for that king. Nishevana, by staying at Varanasi and giving an Anugraha to Marutta king. Next.
Shamsantascha. संवर्तानुजम् आङ्गिरसं सर्वतन्त्रेषु प्रवचन पारदर्शन प्रबन्ध निर्माण प्रतिभा व्यवहार कौशलैः
व्यवहार कौशलैः आङ्गिरसं शंसन्तः सो तस्य प्रतिभा व्यवहार कौशलैः बृहस्पतेः प्रतिभा प्रतिभा इस् नवनव उन्मेषशालिनी प्रतिभा प्रज्ञा द समथिङ्ग् विच् कीप्स् आन् At every point, if there is a new idea that comes up in the brain, that is Pratibha. It is the creativity is called Pratibha. His expertise in different, in the... How do we know about the creativity of Sparada? Prabandha Nirmana, writing of Grantham or something like that. These are the ways in which the Pratibha Vyavahara, the creativity, the different actions of that creativity, the expertise of that is known to people. So these Shishya, Sanat Kumara's disciples, were discussing about the expertise of Brihaspati. Sasha, and they were praising him by this. So Sarva Tantreshu, Tantram means Siddhantam. In all the Siddhantas that were present in the world, he had an expertise, kaushalam, by exhibiting his pratibha, by showing his creativity in the all the darshanas, in the way of pravachana, paradarshana, prabandha nirmana. Adhiti bodha charana pracharanaihi in Naishadhiyam, the way he will say how vidya, that is learning is imbibed in a person, or when, how does the learning solidify in a person? There are four ways to do it: adhiti, bodha, acharana, pracharana. Adhiti is first learning. You take a text, you are learning it, you're understanding the meaning of it. Next is bodha. Understanding is next one. So adhiti is just studying it, and then bodha. So is equal to, you just say this is the meaning of this word, this is the meaning of this word. That is, you know the meaning of it. But understanding the import is going one more level, which is bodha. Acharana, then you are using it, it is through osmosis, you try to use it in your lifestyle. Acharana, then pracharanam. Only then can you tell people about what it is. If you have not imbibed it within yourself, there is no point in saying word by word meaning. For that, English translation is enough. So it is when you go to a teacher, you're not only getting that learning, you're also getting that adhiti, bodha, his understanding. And then the way that teacher has used it in practice, his experience, all of those things are transmitted through that. So that is very important as far as learning is concerned. So that's why he says here, sarva tantreshu tasya pravachanam. He starts off with adhyapanam, because Brihaspati has finished adhiti, bodha, acharana and everything. So here pravachanam, he teaches. The next step is analysis, paradarshanam. And after that is prabandha nirmanam. He is capable of writing newer shastram and other, because he is the Atharvaveda pravartaka and yogarahasya pravartaka. So he doesn't have to go through adhiti, bodha and acharana. He is already a personification of all that. Right. So sarva tantreshu, he takes it to the next level and says pravachana paradarshana prabandha nirmana pratibha vyavahara kaushalaihi, by talking about these expertise of Brihaspati, samvarta anujam angirasam shamsantaha. They were praising the brother of samvarta Shivacharya, which is Angirasa or Brihaspati. Now when you praise someone, everybody, even Brihaspati, has some minus points. Okay, so the next adjective actually talks of his minus point, but you don't say that too much. Pariharantaha, he starts off with that. Read that.
Pariharantascha lokayatika tantra tirthakarata prayuktam apakarshamapi bahyatantra pravartaka parameshwara nirdarshana upadarshanena.
So here in Niti Shatakam, paraguna paramanuna parvatikritya nityam, adilla, what is the other one? Guhyam niguhati gunan prakatikaroti. Guhyam niguhati gunan prakatikaroti. He uses it in the context of sanmitra lakshanam. And he says, a friend is a person who has to cover up that which has to be covered, and gunan prakati karoti. He should spread the good qualities of everybody everywhere, of his friend everywhere. So paraguna paramanuna, even if there is anuvat yat yaha gunaha vartate parasmin tadapi parvati kritinidhi, you have to show it as if it is a big, huge guna that is there in someone. That is how you have to behave. That is positive thinking. Do not look at the negative aspects at all. So pariharantaha, these Sanat Kumara Shishyaha, they carefully avoided the topic of the fact that Brihaspati also started Charvaka Matam. Lokayatika is the Charvaka Tantram. Lokayatika Tantram, it is the hedonistic way of life. Charu vakaha, charu vadati. So he is a person who speaks very beautifully. Rinam dattva ghritam pibet. Take, you know, you can loan, take a loan, have ghee every day. Don't worry about anything after death. There is nothing after death. No punarjanma, no papam, no punyam, nothing of that sort. You live your life only once. That is the lokayatika tantra. So that does not prompt, see, the karma theory and punarjanma, papam, punyam, all of these concepts came about in a way to make people do good. if you say that you are going to live life only once, nobody is going to be bound by the goodness of it. It's very easy to go into the wrong path. So the Lokayatika Tantram is not greatly appreciated in that manner. So Lokayatika Tantra Tirtha, Tirtha Samoham. Lokayatika Anam Grantha Anam Samoham Tat Karata, Karaha Kumbhaka. So Karata means praneta. So praneta is karaha. So lokayatika tantra karaha, one who has written that charvaka tantram also, charvaka matam also, he has written only Brihaspati. And that quality of his, lokayatika tantra karasya bhavaha lokayantrika, lokayatika tantra karata. Tat prayuktam apakarsham. Apakarsham is the apakirti that he has, the ill fame that Brihaspati has, which has come from the quality of his having written the Lokayatika Tantra, the Charvaka Matam, that they carefully avoided it. Why? How did they avoid it? Well, we don't need to talk about it much, you know, even Shiva has indulged in that. So what is that here? Bahya Tantra Pravartaka Parameshwara Nidarshana Upadarshanena. They use Shiva as a Nidarshana, as an Upama. Upadarshanena, by highlighting Shiva as an example for this. How was Shiva an example? So that Bahya Tantram, a very specific word that he uses here, where Pancharatram Pashupatam Tatha Vaikhanasabidam Vedabrashtana Samuddishya Kamalapati Ruktavan. Bahya Tantram means Avaidika Siddhantaha, Avaidika, which does not follow the Vaidika Tantra. So they have a separate agama. They do not follow the Veda agama. Don't mistake it by saying that Pashupata, Pancharatra, Vaikhanasa and all are not Shruti followers. They have their agama texts which they follow. There is a Shaivagama, there is a Pancharatra agama, there is a Vaikhanasa agama which they follow. They do not follow the four Vedas to the letter. That is followed only by the Mimamsaka, which is separate. So these Pashupata, etc., those are all called as Bahya Tantra. So those Bahya Tantra, which do not follow the Vedas in proper, so they are called Veda Brashtaha. Those which have been Brashta means banished by the Veda, or they have banished the Vedas, I think. So these are called Bahya Tantra. Tadrisha Bahya Tantrana Yaha Pravartayati, that is Parameshwaraha Shivaha, Tasya Nidarshana Upadarshanena Ullekhena, by showing Shiva as a Bahya Dasi. Even Shiva has started all these Bahya Tantram, which is completely away from Veda. So it is okay. We don't need to talk highly about, we don't need to say gossip about the fact that Brihaspati has started Charvaka Matam. So tat pariharanta, apakarshamapi pariharantaha, by avoiding that ill fame, and then they came to Suraguru. Samagamya
yathavidhi sannatascha swagurau iva sahashishyaihi suracharyam saratkumara samipam anindire.
So samagamya yathavidhi, samagamya, arriving there, coming to that place. Yathavidhi, as per rule, just as, when they meet Suraguru, how they have to behave to that person, that is Yathavidhi, Vidhi Manasikramya. Swagurau Iva Sannataha, Santaha, Te Shishyaha, Sanatkumara Shishyaha, Swagurau Yata Namratam Darshayanti, Tatha Suraguru Api Namratam Darshayanti, Sannataha, Nataha, Samyak, Nataha. They bow very in a respectful manner to him, as they would to Sanat Kumara. Tatha Shishyaihi Saha Suracharyam, along with his Shishyas, who are the Devas, along with the Devas, Suracharyam, Sanat Kumara Samipam, Anindire, they brought him. Anayati, I think it's the little akara of Anayati. So Anindire, the Shishya, Sanat Kumara's disciples, brought Suraguru and the Amaras, Devas, to Sanat Kumara. Okay.
Sanat Kumarena Samagame Guruho Nishamya Vritta Vividhas Tadarhanaha Nishamya Vadeshvatha Chasya Chaturim Vishishya Tasmin Namara Tasmin Namara Vinimire Vinemire
Vinemire Tasmin Amaraha Vinemire. The Sanat Kumara's disciples showed a lot of respect after the Atithi Puja. So they showed a respect to Suraguru. And then when Suraguru came near, Sanat Kumara, talked about the expertise of Suraguru to everybody there. So he said, this Brihaspati is so good in Vada, Vada Prativada. And when he talked about the expertise of Suraguru, all the devas became even more humble in front of him. That's the idea in this shloka. One minute. I thought I had written that. Okay. So, Sanatku Samagame, Guroho Samagame Sahi. Guruho, when Suraguru had arrived, Guruho Samagame Sati, after all the Atithi Puja, Tad Arhanaha, Vividaha, Vrittaha, Guruho. Oh, 1 minute. Oh, no. Okay. So the Anvayam here goes like this: Guruho Samagame. When Suraguru had come there, Guruho Samagame Sati, Tad Arhanaha Tasmai Vihitaha Pujaha. So those different Atithi Puja that was given, Arhana, Arha means Yogyata, he is the capability, what do I say, the Puja Arhaha, you say. So Arhana means Puja. Pujanam, all the different types of vividaha, tadarhanaha, the aneka vidaha, whatever puja are there, madhuparkam and atithi puja is there, right? So all of those nishamya, after seeing all those, overseeing, after supervising all the atithi puja, the different atithi puja that had happened there, vrittaha, tadarhanaha, vrittaha, bhutaha, jataha, pujas that had happened at that point of time when Suraguru had arrived. So, Guruho Samagame Sati, Tadarthe Kritaha Vrittaha Arhanaha Vividaha Arhanaha Vividaha Pujaha Nishamya Drishtva. After seeing Sanat Kumarena Tasya Chaturim Nishamya. The difference between Nishamya and Nishamya, he says, is Nishamya means Drishtva, whereas Nishamya means shrutva, the shamaha darshane api asti. So there is the dirgham is for drishtva and hraswam is for shrutva. So nishamya, atha, after the puja had been done, asya brihaspatehe chaturim vadeshu chaturim cha nishamya. After hearing about his expertise, chaturim, his greatness in vadeshu, vakyartheshu. Vakyartha Sadas means where someone is saying something, uttaram, prashnam, uttaram, prashnakaranam, shankha, all of these are called vada. Anuttara prashnakarana, anashanka utthana, uttara pradana. So when there is no answer, you ask a question which cannot be answered. So the Vadeshu Chaturi means where he has an expertise in Vada or argument. What type of expertise is that? He can ask a question. Suraguru can ask a question for which there can be no answer. Nobody can answer. Karana Anashanka, nobody can find out a karanam for it, something that they are saying. And Uttana Uttara Pradhanam. So Anashanka Uttana Uttara Pradhanam. Even though nobody has any doubt, he can say, you might have this. doubt. So let me answer that doubt. He is capable of prashnam. He can give the answer for the prashnam. He can also start off a shanka, a doubt which nobody has, and give an answer to that doubt also. Tadrishi chaturi asit suraguroho. So asya suraguroho vadeshu chaturim nishamya uktva tasmin amaraha. After they heard from Sanat Kumara, Sanat Kumarena nishamya, after hearing from Sanat Kumara the greatness of suraguru, amaraha the devas, tasmin suragurau vishishya vinemire, they became even more humble towards suraguru. Sanat Kumarena samagame guroho. You have a doubt?
No, I can't. Oh. Getting ready to read the next
one. Sure, go ahead. Next one.
Yeah. Angirasopi pranamya bhaktya mahatya parameshthinamiva Sanat Kumaram avedya devakaryam anugyapya cha tena pakashasanam anuvrajya parishvajya gadham adishya chaturmukha upasarpana iti kartavyatam anugrihya shivena chetasa visrishtastena vinayata vinayati
vinaya atishayat
vinaya atishayat adrishti pathadadhana shirasyanjalim asthaya mahantam yogam avartayan pranavameva saha amaraihi asasad mahatavadhanena hairanya garbhamayatanam
hairanya garbham ayatanam asasad saha amaraihi. So the paragraph starts with Angirasaha api, Brihaspatirapi, Amaraihi saha, Devaihi saha, Mahata avadhanena, with a great concentration, Chitta aikagrena, Hairanyagarbham ayatanam asasada, Brahmalokam asasada, Brahmaloke, Brahmanaha bhavanam asasada. So what happened before that? So Angirasaha api, bhaktya pranamya, he with a great devotion he bowed to Sanat Kumara, who mahatya bhaktya Sanat Kumaram parameshtinam iva pranamya, as how he would do namaskaram to Brahma in the same way. Yatha brahmanam saha namati tatha Sanat Kumaram api paramaya bhaktya namaskritya. So mahatya bhaktya pranamya devakaryam avedya, he let him know what the work has to be done for the devas. So devakaryam means indrasya prayojanam yat asura jayaha tam asura jayam avedya, we need help for that. Anugnyapya cha tena pakashasanam. Now this is a very strange use, not strange, I would say in the Tippani he is given a very nice way to say that. So tena anugnyapya, tena Sanat Kumarena pakashasanam anugnyapya, after giving him permission, giving Indra permission. So this actually Sanat Kumara is giving permission to Indra to go and meet Brahma. Anugnyati anugnyaya, anugnyaya means Sanat Kumaraha pakashasanam anugnyapayati, no, anujanati, he gives him permission. Okay, that you will have it as anugnyaya, whereas here it says anugnyapya, which means nijantam, or it's a causal form. So angiras munihi saha pakashasanam indram anujanati. So Sanat Kumaraha इन्द्रम् अनुजानाति सः इन्द्रम् अनुजानाति तेन गुरुः इन्द्रम् अनुज्ञापयति सनत्कुमार मेक्स् अङ्गिरस् गिव् पर्मिशन् नो नो एक्चुलि अङ्गिरस् मेक्स् सनत्कुमार गिव् पर्मिशन् टु इन्द्र दट्स् हौ द फार्मेशन् गोस् हियर् पुरीर्द I hope you understand how he brings it. Sanatkumarena Guruhu Indram Anugnyapayati. Tasmat Anugnyapana Anantaram Anugnyapya. It is a causal form. Anuvrajya. This is also causal form. So Sanatkumarena Anuvrajya. Sanatkumaraha Gurum Suragurum Anuvrajati. He follows him. Sanatkumara follows him. Everything here is in the passive voice and I'm just changing it into active voice and saying because it's easier to understand. So Anurajya Parishwajya Gadham. He embraces Suraguru tightly. So Gadham Parishwajya Adishya Chaturmukha Upasarpana Iti Kartavyatam. He also advises Suraguru being advised by Sanat Kumara. So that's the way it goes here. So Chaturmukha Upasarpana, how to approach Chaturmukha Brahma. So how it should be done. The procedure to approach Brahma was advised by Sanat Kumara. Adishya, Shivena Chetasa Anugrihya. Shiva Mangala. Mangala Purvaka Anugrihya, he graces him with a very auspicious mind. In his mind, he has only Mangala in his mind. Tena Visrishtaha. Dismissed by Sanat Kumara or given permission by Sanat Kumara. Here also Tena is Sanat Kumarena Visrishtaha. Tyaktaha Suraguru. Vinaya Atishayat. Suraguru has a lot of discipline in his mind. So Vinaya Atishayat, because of modesty, Angiras had his Anjali Baddha. Shirasi Anjalim Adadanaha. A Drishti Patat. Until the range of Sanat Kumara's eyesight was there, till Sanat Kumara could see him, until then Brihaspati had his Anjali. On his head, Shirasi Anjalim Badva. Sanat Kumarasya Drishtipatham Yavat Tavat Paryantam Suraguruhu Swashirasi Anjalim Badva. Kimartham Vinaya Atishayat. Vinaya Atishaya Karanat Anjalim Badva Mahantam Yogam Asthaya. Here Mahantam Yogam is with a great yoga is dhyanam. So ध्याने मग्नः अभूत् मग्ने मग्नं मग्नो भूत्वा आस्थाय प्रणवमेव आवर्तयन् कीपिंग ऑन ही वाज रिसाइटिंग द प्रणव मंत्रम कॉन्स्टेंटली दैट इज व्हेन ही कैन गो विद ऐकाग्र चित्रम सो महता अवधानेन विद अ ग्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ही रीच्ड हिरण्यगर्भम आयतनम आससाद सह अमरैः अलोंग विद द देवास ही रीच्ड द ब्रह्मास अबोड Now Gachantaha Pati, while they were going on the margam, the devas, they heard Vedavakyam and everything. And they also heard the praise of Brahma. They did not even want Swarga because of this. They were so happy to listen to the different Veda Gosham that they did not want the Alpa Swargam that is not even there in their, in the priority, maybe in their priority list, but in the list of, happiness. This is called Nirvruti. This is the bliss that you can get constantly listening to that Veda Gosham. They felt so happy that they did not want Swargam at all. It's described in this shloka. Read that.
Vagdevi Vadanaravinda Galita Brahmodya Vidyashata Grantha Granthi Vibeda Jata
Kutuka
Kutuka Brahmarshi Harshas Tavaihi Karnabhya Karnabhyarna Gataihi Nivritta Nikhila Nikhila Klesha Digi Digi Shastada Nirva
నిర్వవృహు నచ
నిర్వవృహు నచ వవృర్ వవృర్ వ్రణ వ్రణమపి స్వర్గం పునర్ పునర్గాహితుం.
సో వాగ్దేవి వదనారవింద గచ్చంతః పతి యాజ్ దేవర్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ ద మార్గం దే హర్డ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ స్తవ స్తవైః కర్ణాభ్యర్ణ ఆగతైః స్తవైః బ్రహ్మర్షి హర్ష స్తవైః నివృత్త నిఖిల క్లేశాః దిగీశాః తదా నిర్వవృహు నిర్వృతి ఇస్ సుఖం దే ఎంజాయిడ్ బ్లిస్ దే ఆనందం అనుభవంతః ఆసన్. They were experiencing a happiness which they had not experienced before. You remember the journey that they took to arrive at this place. So Satyalokam yada agachantaha, there were so many people who were, you know, ridiculing them and all that. So imagine the amount of manovyatha they must have been experiencing. All that klesham, nikhila klesha, kleshaha, nivrittaha, all those dukkham had gone for them. Why? Because of these stava. Brahmarshi harsha stavaihi. There were a lot of brahmarshis who were all praising, saying shlokas, stotras with the harsha, with happiness. And those brahmarshi, when they were saying those stava, that stotram came near their ears. Karna abhyarna gataihi. Karna samipam agataihi stavaihi. అపగత క్లేశాః దిగీశాః అమరాః తదా తస్మిన్ సమయే నిర్వవృహ సుఖేన ఆసన్. దే వర్ సో హ్యాపీ అబౌట్ దట్. అవ్రణమపి స్వర్గం పునః గాహితుం న వవృహ అవ్రణమపి. ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ దట్ స్వర్గ హ్యాడ్ నో వ్రణం, వ్రణం మీన్స్ వూండ్. సో హియర్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ విదౌట్ ఎనీ బ్లెమిష్, ఇఫ్ సమ్వన్ టుడే కేమ్ అండ్ గేవ్ దట్ స్వర్గ టు ఇంద్ర saying there are no asuras there and the swargam has gone back to the state that it was before. So it had a vranam and that vranam has gone now. So it had a wound, which is the damage that was created by the asuras. All that has, say, imagine that it has magically gone now. It is completely beautiful as it was before. Avranam api swargam punaha gahitum. They to go gahitum praptum na ichchan na vavruhu, they did not want it. They did not wish for a swarga even if it was presented to them in the same manner as it was before it was damaged. Why? Aduna te nirvavruhu vavruhu vrunute. Here with the nir upasarga the meaning changes to sukham. So they've already attained that sukha here by listening to all these stava stotra. How is that stava? That is where the big the samasta padam comes. So Vagdevi Vadana Aravinda Galita Brahma Udya Vidyashata Grantha Granthi Vibheda Jata Kutuka Brahmarshi. These Brahmarshis who are there in the Brahmalokam are not normal Brahmarshis that you hear about or anything. They have just kutuka, their curiosity has come from analyzing the different, you know, the granthi. Granthi means murchu nu solu, all those the knots that are there in the different texts that you find, right? Jatilaha, how do I say that? Difficult passages that are there in many grantha. They analyze that, they constantly argue about it within themselves, and that is how their curiosity has arisen. And with that, they are praising in a very happy manner, which is that harsham is actually brahmanandam. It is not any normal harsha that you find when you get something. It is not the laukika sukham that he is talking about. So Vagdevi Vadana Aravindat Sarasvatyaha Vadanat Yat Galitam. What is that which has come out of her mouth, Saraswati's mouth? That is Brahma Udya, that which praises Udyam Kataniyam. The Vidya, the learning that comes out of Saraswati talks about Brahma. or the Parabrahma Swarupam. The Vidya Shatam, the hundreds of granthas that talk about the different branches of learning, actually points out only to one tattvam, which is the Brahma tattvam. And that Brahma tattvam has come from Vagdevi. Right? All the different branches of learning have come from her mouth. So Vagdevi Vadana Aravindatu Galitam Brahma Udyam Cha Vidya Shatam. Vidya Shatanam Granthanam Granthi. The Granthi Vibede. The different knots that are there in the texts of the different learning, in all the texts, Vibede. They have been trying to untangle those knots that are there in the texts. Tad Vibedena Jata Kutukaha Brahmarshayaha. Their curiosity has arisen because they have tried to untangle the concepts that are there in the different texts. Those, so imagine the intellect that of the Brahmarshis that is there. So there, Harsha Stavaihi, Karna Abhyarna Agataihi Stavaihi, Nivritta Nikhila Kleshaha. Now this Vagdevi Vadana can also be described in another manner. So the first is, it is just an adjective to the Brahmarishis, who are all curious to analyze the different texts that are there. Another is, because they are approaching the Brahmaloka, there are few adjectives for Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma here, which is Vagdevi Vadanaha. Vagdevi Yasya Chaturvadaneshu Vidyate. Brahma has Saraswati in his mouth, that which means he has the learning in his mouth. Tadrisha Chaturmukha Brahma. Hey Brahma, so people are praising Brahma here. They are in Brahma's bhavanam. So they have to naturally, it's like imagine a king is there and every poet who comes there will be praising the king. So here also Vagdevi Vadana. Iti Sambodhana Yapi Bhavitum Arhati. Aravinda Galita. Vishnoho Nabhikamalatu Utpannahasaha. Aravinda Galita. Brahma Udya. Yaha Brahma Vishaye Sarvada Vadati. Brahma Vishaya, Brahma is also means not only Parabrahma Swarupam, Brahma also means Vedaha. Yaha Sarvada Vedameva Uccharayati Tadrishaha Chaturmukha Brahma, Brahmodya. Next, Vidya Shata Grantha Granthi Vibeda Jata Kuduka. He also analyzes the different texts and his curiosity is also in trying to entangle the knots that are there in the different texts. So, Tadrisha Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma, Brahman iti karna abhyarna gataihi brahmarshi harshastavaihi. Evam brahmarshayaha brahmanam stuvanti. They are praising Brahma like this, in this manner, with these four sambodhana adjectives. Iti karna abhyarnam gataihi brahmarshi harshastavaihi. Their klesha dukkha apagata dukkaha amaraha sada sukham anvabhavan swargam na avan. They did not want swarga. So Vagdevi Vadanaravinda Galita Brahmodya Vidya Shata Grantha Granthi Vibeda Jata Kutuka Brahmarshi Harshastavaihi Karna Bhyarna Gataihi Nivritta Nikhila Klesha Digishaha Tada Nirvavruhu Najavabruhu Avranamapi Swargam Punar Gahitu. We'll stop with this. The next is Gadhyam is actually a description of how that Brahma Lokam, Brahma Bhavanam is. There are seven different rooms in that Brahma Bhavanam. He describes each and every room of that place. It's a very nice one. And we'll need time also for that, so we'll do it next class. Yeah. Namaste.